Thank you very much for that introduction. It's a pleasure to be with you here today and to speak to you on behalf of Prime Minister Trudeau and the Government of Canada. The theme of this conference is about movement towards a zero-waste circular economy. Fundamentally, the concept of a zero-waste society is one in which we all are working to make far better use of the world's resources. Given the world's increasing population, and given the finite nature of all earthly resources, a move in the direction of a zero-waste economy is of critical importance for all countries as the world strives towards a more sustainable future. For the sake of future generations and for the sake of the planet, we must stop thinking about waste as something to be disposed of, and we must start to think of what we have heretofore considered waste as a resource. As the organizers of this conference have noted, making significant strides towards such a future will require open minds, creative thinking, and a lot of innovation. The agenda of the current Government of Canada is well aligned with the objectives of this conference. We believe that environmental and economic sustainability must be at the heart of public policy decision making. We also believe that to make the kind of progress that we all desire, we must foster and harness the innovation potential of Canadians. It's no surprise to you in terms of statistics, but Canadians currently generate about 33 million tons of municipal waste per year, the vast majority of which continues to be sent to landfills in our communities. Emissions from landfills contribute about 3% to Canada's greenhouse gas emissions. In recent years, we have collectively made strides in diverting waste in Canada, in large part thanks to municipal and provincial efforts, in particular extended producer responsibility programs and landfill bans of certain types of materials. But our national recycling rate remains at about 25%, while leading countries of the OECD divert some 50 to 60% of their waste and then find ways to utilize much of the balance as a resource. Successes within the OECD can be attributed to a diversity of approaches. Japan and Germany, for example, have put in place comprehensive laws to promote effective resource recovery and enhanced recycling of materials from the waste stream, such as packaging and containers, home appliances, electronics, construction materials, and end-of-life vehicles. The United Kingdom, France, South Korea, and the United States have also shown leadership in developing approaches to reducing food waste through partnership initiatives with retailers, food rescue organizations, and public education campaigns. Canada can learn some things from some of the initiatives that have been taken from these and from communities within our own borders. Together with leading communities and industries across our country, we can pave the road to enhance the recovery, the recycling, and the reuse of all materials. Going forward, we as a society must adopt a new paradigm and send far, far less garbage to landfills. We must use resources much more productively. We have to innovate to capture value from a wider variety of materials and take part in the shift towards a global circular economy. There are a number of elements of the current federal government's policy agenda that are directly relevant to the themes of this conference. Perhaps the two most critical are climate change, which obviously has a significant link to organic waste in particular, and innovation as it relates to the generation of new ideas for enhancing the efficient and effective use of resources, both natural and human. With regard to climate change, I think everyone in this room knows the challenge that climate change poses to the future of the planet, particularly for our children and our grandchildren. We can list all of the ways in which global warming has already begun and will continue to alter the current environment. Addressing climate change both domestically and as a constructive member of the international community is something that the Liberal Party of Canada campaigned on in 2015. It has been and it will continue to be a central part of this government's policy agenda going forward. Addressing climate change is also a priority for many individual Canadians and Canadian businesses. Canadians understand the urgent environmental imperatives that are associated with climate change. They want to ensure that we protect the planet for future generations. The effort to address climate change is actually one of the reasons I got into politics in the first place. As a parent of teenage children, I firmly believe that we have a collective responsibility to ensure that we are leaving our children and our grandchildren a world in which they can not only survive, but thrive. In addition, as somebody who spent the past 20 years as a chief executive officer and a senior executive in BC's clean tech industry, I also think that we as a country need to recognize and take advantage of the enormous economic opportunities that combating climate change represent, as many countries around the world are already doing. Such opportunities are broad. They relate to a range of new technologies, IT, communications, as well as technologies more typically defined as clean tech. Opportunities that are going to be enabled in the coming transition are broad, relating to new processes and systems for reducing carbon footprint and improving efficiency across many existing industries, as well as new business models and new businesses that are emerging and will continue to emerge as we start to think differently about things like industrial, commercial, and residential waste. In the context of the current federal-provincial process aimed at developing a pan-Canadian approach to addressing climate, organic waste has played an important role. Through work on the pan-Canadian strategy, the federal government and the provinces have collectively discussed a number of ways to better address food waste, the management of organics, and recycling and reuse. And many of you likely contributed to some of these conversations either in person or via the online portal relating to the climate action. Implementation of some of these ideas should mean less waste sent to landfills, reduced greenhouse gas emissions, and the preservation of land for other more productive uses. One example of such innovative approaches can be found in the organic facility that's actually being built in Surrey right now, where organic materials are being collected across the municipality. They're being digested. The gas associated with that digestion is being converted into a transportation fuel that will fuel garbage trucks across the municipality. And the residuals will be used as agricultural supplements. With respect to innovation, the importance of innovation to successfully transitioning to a zero-waste economy cannot be understated. To successfully undertake such a transition is going to require innovation in a whole host of ways. People think about it often just as strictly technology, but that will include psychology in terms of how individual Canadians think about and treat what we have previously thought about as being waste. Technologies in terms of how we can better utilize and transform waste. Processes for conversion of current waste into useful products or resources, and business models that turn disposal-based models into models focused on reuse. When I think about innovation, I think about, and the need for driving innovation, I think about firms like Ron and Nate in Richmond. Ron and Nate is developing a technology and a business model for what they call urban mining, where they take old computers and electronics, and through an innovative process, they extract a range of valuable metals. At times, the grade of metals, such as gold, can actually be that can be extracted through the process that they use can be in excess of grades pulled from physical gold mines. This is the type of innovation that can help us make significant strides towards a zero-waste society. A major portion of the current Government of Canada's policy agenda is focused squarely on the development and the execution of an innovation agenda for Canada. The government recognizes very clearly that Canada will need to build on some of its core existing strengths in science, education, natural resources, and technology to ensure that Canada will be a strong and effective participant in the economy of tomorrow. As part of this agenda, the government recognizes the key role that businesses, business models, and technologies associated with taking what had previously been thought of as waste and turning it into valuable resources. In this, we are very well aligned with the goals of this conference. I would also note that actions that can be taken by governments with regard to policy development, regulation, incentives, and other mechanisms are obviously very important to driving forward with a sustainability-focused agenda. However, it is also the case at home that individuals can, through their own actions, take important steps themselves. They can, for example, reduce food waste. They can ensure that they separate their organic wastes and send them back to the municipality, or they can compost. They can rethink their consumption habits, and they can certainly recycle more. Individual actions and the advocacy of individuals on these issues can have a very substantive impact with regard to advancing us towards a zero-waste society. To conclude, the subject that you will be discussing today is an extremely important one. Fundamentally, it is about the sustainability of the planet over the longer term. I want to tell you that the Government of Canada and the Prime Minister of Canada very much support the objectives of this conference. It is critically important that we begin to address the issue of climate change and issues relating to environmental and economic sustainability more generally. I want to thank you for the invitation to be with you today. I thank you for your participation in this important dialogue, and I look forward to hearing the results of your conversations. Thank you very much.